check all billing system related articles in following site: www.pinepad.in/blog, or go to Java Technologies billing system. This is my site, pinepad.in. When you click blog, it will return all Java related technical articles. If you want to see only specific to billing system, go to Java Technology, click billing system. This will return only billing system related articles. Okay. Please follow me on medium.com. The reason I am saying is, if you follow me on medium.com, you will be getting all notification. You will be getting notification if I post any articles in pinepad.in or medium.com. This is the link which is from pinepad.in. This particular post contains all YouTube links which related to billing system. Okay, I will show that. See, billing system using Spring Boot, all YouTube video links updated here. This post contain all YouTube link that related to billing system. Okay, this information I have updated on YouTube description, on YouTube video description. Okay, please check it out. Let's go into the video now. Welcome back, friends. In this video, we are going to talk about offer table and a category table. Okay, this is the offer table. The offer table contains ID is deleted, offer code, offer name, offer description, date created, date modified, and status. And the important column is offer code, offer name, then the status. Then offer description contains a description about the offer name. That's it. Why we need to use offer table? For example, if you want to add any offer to a particular product, in such a case, we need to create an offer record in the offer table. We need to create an offer record in the offer table. Offer is not available for all the time, right? So we need to keep a status, whether the offer is active or after offer is pending or offer is inactive. Like that, we need to maintain the offer with a status. If I don't want to maintain the offer, we need to make the offer record as a inactive. Inactive. Whenever create a new offer, that time offer create with pending status. Whenever client want to active offer, they have to send active status in the backend system, update the offer as an active status. So there are three status: active, inactive, and pending. Offer create by default with the pending status. Once we create the offer, this offer we need to attach to the product. That I'm going to cover while explaining about the product. Okay. In the controller class, I have created a controller class. In the controller class, I have done three different endpoints. One is a saving offer. Saving offer, that is adding a new offer, updating existing offer. Another one is a viewing offer, viewing particular offer. A third one is a view all offer, that is fetch all offers. In this controller, I have auto-wired offer service. Offer service is my service class. In the service class, again, I have created three different methods. One is for save, another one is for finding a particular record, another one is for find all records. The save method, the server method accept the offer info as a parameter. This offer info is a request body which is coming from client side. Here I am converting offer info as an offer object, offer entity object. Then I am checking that offer contains offer code or not. If the offer does not have offer code, I am assuming that if offer does not have offer code, I am assuming that I need to create a new offer record. If offer does not have an offer code, that is offer code is empty, I am assuming that we need to create a new offer. It will come to the F block. Then I am generating a new code for my offer record. Then I am setting that offer code to my offer object. Then I'm setting the status as a pending. By default, I'm setting a status as a pending for new offer. Then I'm passing this offer object to save method of repository classes. This offer repository classes. The repository class does not have anything. I'm using some default method which is coming from JPA repository. After setting a status as a pending, I'm passing this offer to the save method. It will create a new offer in the database, then return that new offer. I'm assigning that new offer to new offer object. Now this object contains with ID, with new offer ID. Then again, I'm converting this offer entity object to my new offer info, new offer info. Then I'm binding this offer info object with my response message, with my response message. Then this response message, I'm returning back to in my controller class. This controller class returns the response message as a response to the client. I think get and the get all method self-explanatory. Okay, if you look at the service class, you can understand very easily. This is very similar to what I did in touch table. Okay, now we're going to see the demo. When I explain about touch table, I missed one thing. Whenever you access any endpoint, you cannot access directly from the one, because I have integrated JW, right? Without JW token, you cannot access any endpoint. Before testing any endpoint, please create access token. Please generate access token. Use that access token to access all endpoint in our system. I'm going to show that now. My offer endpoint is http://localhost/offers. In the body method, we need to write a request body. First, we need to set the header. Content type. Application JSON. Here we need to set authorization. Now I'll try to access the endpoint without setting authorization. Let's see what's happening. In the body section, we need to create a request body. Go to the offer object, offer info object. We need to set offer name and the offer description for creating a new offer. Offer name. I am saying buy one, get one free. Offer description. Sorry. Buy one, get one free offer. Okay, that's it. Two is enough. Status, status we no need to send. While creating a new offer, no need to send the status. Okay, by default, we created with pending. Now we're going to send a request. It gives forbidden error. See, 403 forbidden error. You cannot access without JW token. You cannot access any endpoint in our billing system. We need to generate access token first. This is the endpoint to generate the access token. I'm sending now. This is a new access token generated. Copy this access token and go to the offer endpoint. This offer endpoint must be post method. Then in the header section, add one more header, which is authorization. Then we have to add the access token with the bearer. Bearer space, copy the token. Now send a request. See, offer is created now. Offer ID is 4. Offer code is OFR121130. Then offer name is buy one get one free. Offer description is buy one get one free. Let's check the database now. This is offer table. Already we have one row. I'll go to refresh it. Oh, already there are three rows. The fourth record created. See, the ID is a 4. The fourth record created. Buy one get one free offer. status is pending. Okay. Now we're going to update the offer. For updating offer, just copy this response. After response class step, just copy all the things and paste it here. ID is read, offer code is read, offer name is read, offer description is read. Now I want to change the status as active. When you look at the database, the fourth record is a pending, right? I want change offer status as a active. I'm changing to active here. Now I'm sending a request. See response. We got the response here saying status is equal to active. Let's check in database. See, it's became active. So update also working fine. Like that, you can retrieve the records also. Offer slash two. I'm saying slash two here. If you want to view second record, we need to pass the ID. Okay, whatever record you want to view, you have to pass that respective ID here. Okay, offer slash ID. There is a second record. I want to view that record. The mapping is get mapping. See here, I'm able to get that. I want to view fourth record. I want to get that. Now I want to view all the record. Just to put, just to remove the ID, I keep the endpoint till offers. It's returning all the record. This is the about the offer table. Now we're going to see category table. Category table is a very simple table. We don't have to, it does not have any much information. It has category code, description, name. That's it. That is the three columns, it's a main column. Category code, description, name. I have created a category controller class. Category controller class. Instead of controller class, as usual, I created a category service class. Through category service class, I am saving the new category. I am saving them. I am saving the new category and then retrieving the retrieving the particular category and retrieving all categories. Okay, this is self-explanatory. It's very similar to tax table and the offer table. Also, I have given all the JSON requests here. If you're struggling creating a JSON request, I have given JSON request for you here. Please take a JSON request and change the JSON request accordingly. For example, if you want to update the offer table, if you take this offer update request, you need to change the ID accordingly. Otherwise, it will not work. For example, in your database, ID is having a 5. If you pass this, it will not work. It will go and update the ID 1 offer record. It will not update the ID 5. So, we need to pass correct ID here. Okay, that is the one you need to take care while copying the JSON sample from here. Also, I have given a category also. See, category create request, category update request. No, I have not given category update request. For category update request, add one more column called ID and pass the respective ID. That's it. So, category controller is self-explanatory. Please go through this code. If you have any question, please comment me. Definitely, I'm going to help you out. Definitely, I'm going to help you out. In the next video, I'm going to talk about product and the product item. We need to use category table, offer table, then tax table, part of product and the product item. If you want to add a new product, we need to use product item, category table, offer table, then tax table. Combination of these table only we can create a successful product. We'll go into see next video how to do that. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Please share this video to your friend circle and the colleagues. Please share this video to people who wanted to get real-time product experience. One more thing I forgot to tell. I stopped sharing the repository, my repository. I make it as a private. Okay. If you want to get the latest code, go to pinepad.inside. There is a one menu called downloads menu. Click that downloads menu. It will return this page. Okay. From here, you can download the latest code. When you click download button, it will give you the latest code from the repository. Okay. If you face an issue downloading the file, please let me know. Please comment me. I will going to help you out. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.